This video is about injury prevention, how to protect yourself from neck injury and by extension, the spine. So look, I'm gonna talk about the can opener and how to defend it. So first of all, I already talked about it in other videos. Lay on bottom, please, here, in a close guard. Come closer. Yeah, close your guard and raise your neck. Raise, yeah. So when his head is up, the can opener is literally this. I grab his head, I pull his nose towards his butt, I keep pulling, and Andrea steps. Now, is this something you should do? Yes, but not in this way. So, but first, the danger. Look, if I'm here and I keep pulling Andrea's back, it's put a lot of tension on his spine. Now, relax completely, Andrea, and come with me. If he relaxes, see, it's actually easy for him to take it and push back. It's harder, right? Mm-hmm. So, look, I'm pulling Andrea's head in towards me, okay? Now, if Andreas, if I'm pushing over here and he starts to push away from his hip, and while he keeps his neck bent, that is like putting strength on both sides and it will pop his neck, okay? Now, in Jiu Jitsu, or IBJJF at least, and in many gyms, the can opener has a bad name. Because a can opener has a bad name, we don't do can openers. And because we don't do can openers, we don't learn how to deal with can openers. And then occasionally, on an open mat or, well, it's some gyms, more in MMA gyms even, or gyms who train a bit more loose with the rules, see? Then someone does a can opener and you get injured. And now the can opener is absolutely not a problem if you learn how to deal with it. So first of all, how do you do the can opener safely? Give me your head, please. Would be not to pull. So we have to train this in a safe way. So if you just pull it, you will get injured. So what I do is I use my arms to keep on it off. So I put your head a bit backwards. Harder, right? Mm-hmm. And instead of pulling with my arms, I'm gonna go forward with my head, with my legs. And when I'm here, see, does it hurt your neck?
No.
No, exactly. Can I let go on one point now? See, and just stack him from here. See, push me away. The push is not healthy for you, but at the very least, see, there's no danger for your neck right now. I'm gonna do this control. I made a video about this before. A bit closer. See, about the close guard stack pass. You can watch it at the end. I will put a link. You can watch that, but this one is solely about how to deal with the can opener in the safety. So go back up. So me pulling your head towards me and you pushing away from your hips without doing anything with your head, this is as healthy as, or even worse, as squatting with a bent spine. You should not do that. You should not put strength on a bad structure. First fix the structure. So what is the problem with the Andrea structure right now? His spine is bent and his neck is bent. So first of all, so you have to fix the weakest link. You are your head. If you break your neck, that's where the rest of your life is going to live in. So what is Andreas going to do? He's going to work slowly towards the rock bottom. So raise your chin up, please. Look, he first starts to engage his neck. So bend a little bit more. No, back, bend, yeah. So the moment he's here, see if I catch, the moment I go, raise your chin. Yeah, great. This is like in a tie clinch. I pull. Very hard to do. Now, when you're here, raise your nose even higher, Andreas. Okay, now the next thing, engage your back and your shoulders. Exactly. Great. See? And now from here, engage your back as well. Yeah, exactly. And now what Andreas is doing is also making his back hollow. Go back, please. Put your head over there, feet over there. I call this a rock bottom. I talked about it in other videos before. But it's like, why a rock bottom? It's solid, and it's also the worst it should ever get. If you learn this, then back injuries should be non-existent. I get a lot of questions. I made a video recently about how to deal with how to prevent hernia and how to roll when you have a hernia. When you have a hernia or afraid of back injury, roll with a straight spine. Yeah, you have some limits in your motions. Because of course, if you don't bend, it's like one thing you don't do. But at the very least, you can roll until you're healed or maybe for the rest of your life. And I rolled like this for 5 years when I injured my spine. Now look, when you're here, raise your chin up. Engage, do your mannequin arms, so do like here, hands outside, yes here, engage your back, curl your toes, and that's it. And from here you can still do the baby bridge, head backwards, go back. See, now Andreas made one mistake. Look, what he did, make your baby bridge, see, his hip moves, see, he actually moves something with his hip. What you should do right now, see, my hands should not be moving, so focus more and bring your head backwards. You can turn your knees to the floor, that's okay, but move your head more backwards. Yeah, go back. So your hip raises as a result, is not actively pressed up. You feel the difference?
Yeah.
Okay, great. That's what it works towards. So do the rock bottom again, Front bottom is good if I can pass my hand. Raise your hip up. This is definitely still useful, but not the rock bottom. And now it actually bends your neck. So if you want to do a back bridge, then do a full back bridge. Beautiful, go back. But since this is a bit dangerous, I cannot confidently say you should do full back bridges. So that's why we do the baby bridge. Go sideways. It allows you to full back extension and neck extension while being safe. I can jump on this and you will not injure your neck. So now again, so what do we do? One more from here, one from the side angle, from close. Someone catches your head. So the cure from here, raise your chin. Yeah, engage your shoulders. Yeah. You can even open your legs if needed, but not necessarily in this case. And now do the rock bottom, open your back. That's it. Great. And I'm going to try to lift up very hard. That's the cure. The prevention is just to stay in a position to begin with. Like this. Yeah. If you have a neck injury, put your head up, please. If you have a neck injury, don't lift your head because they will grab it. This is true in many positions. So you keep your head on the floor, raise your chin, and you fight from here. I'm going to try to grab you. Like, look, there's baby bridge. Yeah, well, if my hand is here, baby is on the other side. So you walk your head. See, what does this do? Look, right away, it offers back. You push my elbow a bit. Oh, so I have to react to this. So when someone baby bridges this way, I have to be sure I'm on the other side. And then it goes to the other side. This is literally, and now, from here, pull me in. This is already leading into how I address the closed guard. So literally this, see, keep your head up, see, and that's it. And then when someone grabs your head or does grab it, see, it's safe. And if you start pulling it up, look over your shoulder on this side and start baby reaching. And even if I bring it up, see, if I should bring it up, open your elbow, technical, do the Turkish get up. And it actually leads into a hip bump. Everything makes way more sense if you start learning to play with a rock bottom, like with a straight spine, like this. And if you learn to put your nose on the floor. So, but okay, I will actually mention this. You do the baby bridge. Now you can choose a side. Okay, and now come straight up towards me. Come up. And I can easily stop him. Okay, make baby bridge. Put your nose into the floor. Yeah. And now come up by opening your elbow. Exactly, I couldn't stop that. I can stop him. Come up, please. It's a much slower way to come up, but, and it's hard to get open tighter, but every step you conquered, it's hard for you to take it back. Should I push? It's like the octopus guard, where he can go to my back, and if I lean back, he can hip bump. But it's, and if I lean forward, he can grab my legs, see? And he can even go to, well, I'm not going too far into it now, but he could enter the K guard as well. See, so go back close here. So, come straight up, go, come up, up, up. This is the fast way up. Which works if you do it fast on the right moment, and it's a slow way, which always works, and it's just like grinding your way through it. Much safer your spine as well. This was actually the first point in this video about how to keep your neck safe from the can opener. And this applies, of course, in many different positions. Go to the single leg, please, single leg X. The first thing I'm looking for, single leg X, see here, is the head is up, okay, I will grab the head. See, and then I have to fix the head, spine, and now I'm only in danger. See, if I lose the head, so tap, yeah, so good. So, learn to fight with a chin forward, engage back, just like you would be doing in a clinch. So if you like this, make sure to give a thumbs up, put this in your game. Let me know, is any one of you actually, who of you actually suffers from a hernia, who's got a bad back, do you have... Is there anyone with neck problems? I'm planning to make more videos about injury prevention as well. Because I think it's a very useful and very understudied topic and probably the most important thing because we want to have people training the rest of their lives safely. So if you have a specific injury that you want to tell me about it and I will tell you how you can roll with an injury or give my best take on it, how you roll with it and also how to prevent it. So make sure if you want to keep up to date for my videos, there's a link here where you can subscribe to my website. It's not going to spam you, just like an email list where I will send you an update once a month of the stuff that I put out, the articles and the videos that I made.